Transplantation is just a marvel of modern medicine. There's the surgery, but then there's all the lifelong care that goes afterwards. The transplant center here is focused on getting the treatments that'll make a transplant last a lifetime. Started to develop some transplant models, but ultimately identified a protocol that looked like it was worthy to be tested in humans.
My goal is to focus our animal resources to support science. We work closely with the Emory Transplant Center. The data from the non-human primate studies directly used to test this new drug, belatacept, in people, paved the way for approval as one of the first new drugs approved for kidney transplantation in decades.
I was 24 years old. I was on dialysis, so I didn't really have a lot of time. Didn't know what the next day would hold, but I knew I had to keep my head up.
Being a retired soldier, I've been through many things. I've never been through anything like that. I went to see the counselor. Mr. Fowler, you had stage 5 kidney failure.
The spirit of collaboration makes things possible.
This is the infrastructure that we provide that allows scientists to see their concepts put into action and then ultimately impact human health.
I knew at that point that I had another chance. I consider myself, again, lucky that I was able to take belatacept. When I started taking this medicine, it was new, and I thought it was exciting, and I wanted to be part of it. I would hope it would be better, and it has been.
We still are learning how to use the drug, but it's not toxic to the kidney. What belatacept, I think, is kind of the cornerstone of is a new wave of therapies. It's a different class of drugs. I think it probably would not have been developed if it was not for the Emory Primate Center.
Knowing that your body is still adjusting to a new organ, the bela and other medication is keeping your body from attacking your kidney, so the medication is working.
I was so lucky to have Dr. Larsen. I live like a normal human being, and that's really all I could ask for. There's no place else in the world that I would rather be.
I think one of the things that's special and different about transplantation as a surgeon is the relationships that you form with your patients. We have a relationship that lasts hopefully a lifetime, but that to me is real bench to bedside. When you can follow that through, take advantage of things like the Primate Center, that's what we're really trying to achieve.
In the military and in life, leadership is basically influencing people in such a way that they want to accomplish the mission. I'm here to report to the commander of this hospital that mission was accomplished.
Amen.